Hello friends, we'll be today learning something about exporters. We are actually going to learn how exporters can hedge their risk. Let's take a simple example. I am an exporter who have sold goods worth $1 lakh in USA, and this money is receivable after 6 months. So I will be receiving $1 lakh after 6 months and spot rate of dollar. Let me not take bid and ask, but the spot rate of dollar is 70 rupees per dollar. So what is my expectation? My expectation is I'll be getting 70 lakhs rupees from this transaction at the end of 6 months. Now let's talk about the risk. What is the risk? This is my risk. This price, the price of dollar, will fall. See, in extreme cases, if this price after 6 months becomes 60, instead of 70 lakhs rupees in Indian currency, I will be getting only 60 lakhs rupees in Indian currency if the market price becomes 60. So there is a risk which I can nullify, I can hedge, I can reduce this risk. There are n numbers of instruments available. I'll be talking some basic instruments to hedge the risk about those exporters. Number one, it is a future or forward. So what is the difference between future and forward? This is traded in lots. This is traded one-to-one. This is traded by market. This is traded over the counter. What to do? Very simple. Sell $1 lakh after 6 months in future or forward. So there will be an agreement between me and some another person, say it is forward, whereby he is ready to pay me, say, 69 rupees per dollar at the end of 6 months in exchange of $1, and I'll be exchanging totally $1 lakh as well. So enter into forward or future contract and I will be receiving a certain amount after 6 months. Say 6 months forward is available at $1 lakh into 69, that is 69 lakhs rupees will be my certain amount. You will say, sir, it is less than 70 lakhs. So first I was going to get 70 lakhs rupees. Point number one, I was never going to get 70 lakhs rupees because 70 is a spot rate and I'm not going to receive $1 lakh today. I'm going to receive after 6 months. Sir, I've lost 1 lakh rupees. No, by taking this forward, I have made a certain amount of 69 lakhs rupees. Had I not taken this forward, understand, if the rate becomes 60, I will be getting only 60 lakhs rupees. If the rate becomes 50, I'll be getting only 50 lakhs rupees. Now it is certain that whatever is the rate, I'll be getting 69 lakhs rupees. You'll tell me, what if the price becomes 75? Understand, then also I will be receiving only 69 lakhs rupees because this is a forward and or future, which is compulsory contract. I'll have to lock in my 69 lakhs rupees. So if there is increase in rate, you will not be benefited. But my question is, Is your risk hedge? The answer is yes. Now you are not concerned about a falling off dollar because you are going to have 69 lakhs rupees, which is a certain amount. Why people enter into this type of contract? Sir, we are hedging our risk also, but we are nullifying our profit also if the price increases. Understand? People want to concentrate not on the price of dollar, but on their business. Now, if they are locked in with 69 lakhs rupees, they can concentrate more on the business rather than seeing rupees and dollar price daily. So, people enter into forward and future contract. Is it all right? There is also an option available whereby increase in this rate you will be benefited, decrease in this rate your risk will be hedged, which is nothing but option. That option is option. What will happen in option is very simple. Try to concentrate. You will sell $1 lakh after 6 months at a predetermined exercise price, say 69.50 rupees, and this position is known as a long. You are having an option to sell long put option. What will happen if the price decreases? You can sell it in the option. So you will be getting 69,50,000 rupees if the price of the dollar increases less than 69.50 rupees. If the price increases, you can sell it in the market. Can you sell it in the market? The answer is yes. Here you are having an option, but this comes with a premium. You'll have to pay the premium for having this type of option, and you will be paying your premium. By paying a premium, you can lock in your risk and you can keep open your profit. So if the price increases, you will be getting a profit. If the price decreases, you are hedged against that risk. Third option, is money market. See, what is money market option? Is it all? You are going to receive $1 lakh after 6 months, then borrow dollars in USA, borrow dollars at an interest rate which is applicable to dollars, such an amount which is maturing at exactly $1 lakh. So, suppose the let me take a rate of interest, say it is 5% in USA per annum, say 10% per annum. This much higher is not in USA, but still let us take 10% per annum. This is 6 months, is it all right? So, it is 5%, so 1 lakh divided by 1.05 is $95,238. It is $95,238. Borrowed at 10% interest, at the end of 6 months, what is payable will be $1 lakh on this loan, and we will be receiving $1 lakh, and this account will be automatically settled. Sir, what about the borrowed dollar today? Convert it into rupees at a spot rate. Conversion at spot rate does not carry any risk. Can you convert this money at 70 rupees? Yes, because this is a spot rate. This is rate as on today. So 95,238 multiplied by 70, you will be receiving 66,66,000. 660 rupees. You have received it today because you have borrowed dollar, converted into rupees. A borrowed dollar will be repayable after 6 months, but you are going to receive after 6 months. So this 1 lakh will be tallied. But today you have received 66,66,660. You can invest in India, say at the rate of 12% per annum. What you will be receiving after 6 months, it will be plus 6%. It is 70,66,659 rupees. And there is no risk in receiving this amount. This is a certain amount. Whatever is the market price after 6 months of dollar, you will be receiving this amount in rupees. Sir, what about the loan that we have taken? You'll have to repay dollar 1 lakh, but you are going to receive 1 lakh after 6 months. So that will be settled. Payable is 1 lakh, receivable is 1 lakh dollar, and that will be settled. But net, you'll be receiving 70,66,659. This is the three ways in which you can hedge your risk if you are a exporter. Thank you, friends.